Cause nobody deals with Aretha, a mother with four children having to hit the road. They always say after she comes home, but nobody ever says what it's like to get on a plane for a three-week tour. The elation of the first couple of audiences, the good feeling of exchange, the running on the high you get from singing good and loud and long, telling the world what's on your mind. Then comes the eighth show on the sixth day, the beginning to smell like that plane or bus. The if you forget your toothbrush in one spot, you can't brush until the second show. The strangers pulling at you cause they love you, but you having no love to give back. The singing the same songs night after night, day after day. And if you read the gossip columns, the rumors that your husband is only after your fame. The wondering if your children will be glad to see you, and maybe the not caring if they are. The scheming to get out of just one show and go just one place where some dodo doopity doop won't say, just sing one song, please. Nobody mentions how it feels to become a freak because you have talent, and how no one gives a damn how you feel, but only cares that Aretha Franklin is here. Like maybe that'll stop chickens from frying, eggs from being laid, or crackers from hating. And if you say you're lonely or scared or tired, how they always just say, aw, come off it. Or, did you see how they love you? Did you see, huh, did you? Which most likely has nothing to do with you anyway. And I'm not saying Aretha shouldn't have talent, and I'm certainly not saying she should quit singing. But as much as I love her, I'd vote yes to her doing four concerts a year and staying home or doing whatever she wants and making records, because it's a shame the way we're killing her. We eat up artists like there's going to be a famine at the end of those 3 minutes, when there are, in fact, an abundance of talents just waiting. Let's put some of the giants away for a while and deal with them like they have a life to lead. Aretha doesn't have to relive Billie Holiday's life, doesn't have to relive Donna Washington's death, but who's going to stop the pattern? She's more important than her music if they must be separated, and they should be separated when she has to pass out before anyone recognizes she needs a rest. And I say I need Aretha's music. She's undoubtedly the one person who put everyone on notice. She revived Johnny Ace and remembered Lil Green. Aretha sings I Say a Little Prayer, and Dion doesn't want to hear it anymore. Aretha sings Money Won't Change You, but James Brown can't sing Respect. The advent of Aretha pulled Ray Charles from Marlboro Country and back into the blues. Made Nancy Wilson try one more time. Forced Dion to make a choice. She opted for the movies, and Diana Ross had to get an Afro wig. Pushed every black singer into blackness and Negro entertainers into Negroness. You couldn't jive when she said, you make me feel. The Blazers had to reply, gotta let a man be a man. Aretha said, when my show was in the lost and found, you came along to claim it. And Janis Joplin said, maybe. There has been no musician whom her very presence hasn't affected. When Humphrey wanted her to campaign, she said, a woman's only human. And he pressured James Brown. They removed Otis Redding because the combination was too strong. The Impressions had to say, Lord have mercy, we're moving on up. The black songs started coming from the singers on stage and the dancers in the streets. Aretha was the riot, was the leader. If she had said, come, let's do it, it would have been done. Temptations say, why don't we think about it, think about it, think about it.
Told me If you're driving in your car, watch what you're doing and sing. La 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 la. La 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 la